Project VoiceScape is a project of Adobe Youth Voices, Adobe Foundation's Global Signature Philanthropy Program, POV, Point of View, public television's longest-running showcase for independent nonfiction films, and PBS. They awarded grants to 15 projects by high school and middle school students who created documentaries about issues important to them. Alejandra Gama, a student at Millennium High School in Goodyear, was chosen as one of 15 teens across the country to film a documentary. We'll talk to Alejandra in a moment, but first let's take a look at some of her film, Right to be an American.
Say, dile, vale, vale, dile.
Hey, how are you doing, dile? Come on.
I'm doing.
Dile, come on.
Come on.
Come on.
Dile, Camila, come on.
Let's go.
Go. ¿Qué les preocupa del futuro de sus hijas?
A mí me preocupa que las quieran privar de los derechos que tienen por ser nacidas aquí y de padres indocumentados.
January 27th, 2011. The Arizona legislature proposes two of its most controversial bills, House Bill 2561 and House Bill 2562. Both aim at changing the 14th Amendment so children of undocumented immigrants who are born in the United States no longer have the right to automatic citizenship. As I stare at the screen reading the news article covering this, I hear so many voices and sides of the argument, but the one side I do not hear is that of the children themselves. Is no one speaking for these young Americans in an argument that would change their lives forever? Valeria and Camila are two normal sisters with little on their minds but playtime. However, these toddlers face a world of strife just because of their parents' legal status.
With me now is student filmmaker Alejandra Gama. Alejandra, welcome to Horizonte. A fascinating project that you were involved in. Congratulations on being selected to do this. Let's talk a little bit about how it came to be that you were even interested in doing filming. You had some prior experience, I understand.
There was a film class offered at my school, and I thought it'd be interesting. However, once I started the class, I just grew completely enamored with the topic in itself, and that's where I decided what I wanted to do for the rest of my life.
So you're now set on a course to be a filmmaker. That's what you want to go to college and do afterwards?
Yes.
So you had a teacher, though, who talked to you specifically about this project. What did he say to you?
He always encouraged our involvement in outside projects beyond just school, and he told us about Project VoiceScape and how it was a very good opportunity. We had never done documentary work ourselves, but he always encouraged us to learn as we go.
And he told you about this program that's offered by Point of View, which is an award-winning documentary arm kind of PBS, and encouraged you to apply.
Yes.
And so we talked a little bit off camera, and you told me about the different skills that are involved in filmmaking, and it's actually a combination of the kind of skills you would use as a writer, mm-hmm. you've done some writing, and those as a filmmaker. Explain that to us.
Well, you're telling a story. However, it involves different aspects. As a writer, you leave much of the image that the reader sees to their imagination, but as a filmmaker, you give it to the audience. So you have to make sure that you show the right things in order to tell your story in the right way and not confuse the audience or not say something that you don't mean.
How did you decide that you were going to do a film about this particular topic, birthright citizenship?
Well, I had several topics in mind when I decided that I was going to enter the competition. However, this specific topic just, it called me more. I don't understand necessarily why. However, once I started the project, once I began to do more research, it was more so to give a voice where I felt someone was being unheard.
And just to make clear for our audience, what we're talking about are proposals that were raised in the Arizona State Legislature, resolutions really, because they mm-hmm. can't affect the Constitution directly, to change the 14th Amendment to the U.S. Constitution so that it would prohibit citizenship for children born in the United States unless one or their parents was here legally. Is that right?
Yes.
And so you decided that was your topic, mm-hmm. and how did you decide that you were going to do your documentary by focusing on a particular family or families?
Why I chose that specific family?
Well, as opposed to, let's say, going and interviewing legislators or talking to people, legal scholars, about what the 14th Amendment meant and how it should be applied, mm-hmm. why focus on specific individuals?
Well, because though I did have the president of board of directors of the ACLU and an immigration attorney, I felt it was better to give that side because there wasn't much light on it. You had no idea what exactly these families were thinking. You could easily research the thoughts on this resolution by legislators.
But you wanted to focus on the people affected by this.
Yes.
And the particular family that's shown in the documentary, how did you come across them?
They are a family that I had known from church. And when I was making the proposal, I knew about their situation and I approached them about it. And from the very beginning, they were very trusting with me, which was very good. You need your subject's trust.
But there were other people who didn't want to participate, is that right?
Yes,
I did. And why was that?
Fear. They're putting yourself out there as an undocumented immigrant is very frightening in Arizona.
They were afraid that they'd be exposed and maybe deported. And we're showing some of the film on TV. It's a family with a little girl?
Mm-hmm. Two.
With two little girls. And how long had they been in the United States?
The mother has been since 2006, and I think the father since 2003. I can't remember exactly. So about 8 and 5 years.
And in a segment that I saw, because I watched the whole thing, it's clear that the parents not only feel strongly about their children being considered Americans, because mm-hmm. They were born here, mm-hmm. but that they themselves view the United States as their second home. How did you feel about that? What the expressions that they had about their strength of affection for this country?
I thought it was both interesting, and I wasn't surprised. Because home is not necessarily dictated by status, legal status in this sense. It's more dictated by where you live, where you find the people that you love. I think they consider it more their home because this is their daughter's base. This is where they want their daughters to grow up. This is the only place their daughters know.
There's another part of the film that we didn't show where you go and you interview quote-unquote Americans, about their views on birthright citizenship. Tell us about that.
Well, this past 4th of July, I went out into a 4th of July public celebration, and I just asked random citizens what their thoughts were on this, how they thought it would affect things, just to show more than one perspective. So, not just the families or the president of the board of the directors from ACLU or the lawyers, but also to give that angle and the film overall a well-rounded amount of voices and opinions.
And you did get a variety of opinions on that specific subject.
Yes, I did.
Any surprises?
No, I was prepared for everything. I knew that not everybody would think like me, and I was very open to that. It was interesting because I would also ask them, why they felt that way. It was interesting to hear why people's reasoning behind things. Sometimes it didn't make sense to me, sometimes it did.
And when we spoke a little earlier this evening, you indicated that some people seemed to be changing their mind almost as they were articulating what their views were.
Well, because the subject does touch on children, it's very easy to start, though you may have one side, if the other side has children, you tend to start feeling compassion towards them because they're so innocent. I think maybe that's why. But most of the answers that I received from those interviews were very moderate. People may not necessarily be for an immigration reform, and they may have accepted a law like SB 1070, but this is something different. It was kind of like a different realm because it was aimed at illegal immigrants in a sense, but at the end of the day it would mostly affect their children. So it made people look at a different perspective.
Now, in October, this aired, right? And was it on PBS or on the internet?
On the POV blog, there was all the films actually from Project VoiceScape are on there.
And what kind of reaction have you gotten to your film?
Very positive ones, encouraging ones. There was one reaction specifically where a family friend of ours, he was very happy with me because as a youth I was expressing my opinion, not so much my opinion, but I was mobilizing my thoughts and voicing myself, even though it's not directly what I think of the subject, it was still me doing something for what I believe in, and which is something I stand for too. Even I can't vote, so I made a film.
Let me ask you real quickly, because we're almost out of time, what's next for you? What do you plan to do next?
College. I'm still making some short films. I've been very busy lately because I am a senior and I have to finish all my applications, and I'm in several rigorous courses right now. But beyond that, I just hope to finish college. I hope to get a doctorate in both literature and filmmaking. And then beyond that, I hope to become a filmmaker.
Well, we wish you the very best and thanks for joining us on Horizonte.
Thank you very much.
That is our show for tonight. From all of us here at Horizonte, I'm Jose Cardenas. Have a good evening.